Welcome to my channel. I am Pooja and today I'm going to talk about how you can grow your own butterflies in your garden or in your balcony garden, in your balcony, or if you have like a windowsill, even that would work if you just take care of it. When I say growing butterflies, I don't mean keeping them trapped in your house. I mean helping them emerge out of the cocoon and then letting them go and fly and live in the world. So in my balcony, I have two plants, a lemon plant and a curry plant, and both these plants attract butterflies towards them to lay eggs on these plants. That's how I first got introduced to the entire process as well. Initially, when I noticed these caterpillars on my plants, I just let them be. I thought, they will grow on their own and they will just emerge and, the nature will take its course. But what I noticed is, because I live on the second floor, there used to be at times there was the wind would drop the cocoons or, will shake them up a little bit, or the birds will nibble at the caterpillars and all of that. So I realized that after a point of time, they used to die. So I did my little research and I checked how to go about it, and then I realized maybe I can just help them grow. So what I did is I took a 5-liter Bisleri bottle and I poked a lot of holes in it, like the entire bottle is made up of holes now. I even poked holes in the top cap, so there is enough ventilation and they don't suffocate. So I ensure that everything, the air is constantly moving in and out of the thing. What I ensure that the base didn't have a lot of holes, it just had some holes in case the rainwater gets in, but not a lot of water in it. I then cut out a door on the side of the bottle and just taped it shut. So when the butterflies emerge, I would just open the door and the butterfly could fly out. Now once you have this box ready, you can make it of anything. If you have a rectangular box, if you have anything which has a little space and the caterpillars can walk around in it, it's fine. The 5-liter bottle also is working fine for me. I have done I have released at least 15-20 butterflies up until now, and they all have just worked fine in the same bottle. And I just once the butterfly flies away, I remove everything and I wash it off properly, and I can just reuse it again. So once you have the box ready, the entire process is very simple. You just need to have you just need to wait for a caterpillar to arrive on your plant, and once it does, you can just take it and put it in the box. And now you need to feed it every day. Ensure that you feed it every day because it eats a lot. It looks like a tiny thing, but you will see it change almost every day. If it is this much today, tomorrow it will be this much. It will be this much. And in a week, you must have seen it grow a lot. So it eats a lot, it needs a lot of food. So please ensure that you give them fresh leaves every day. They eat lemon plant leaves and the curry leaf plant. I just give them lemon leaves because that's what they have been eating for so long. So I have just kept that one plant for the butterflies. That's why I ensure that I don't use pesticides on it as well, because then I'm feeding it to them, so I don't want to kill them. So then this one plant I have kept, which is pesticide free, which I keep giving the butterflies, and they are working fine and they're eating it, they're liking it and everything nice. Now since they eat a lot, they're going to poop a lot as well. So if you have a rectangular box, you will have to clean the poop all the time, every day. You don't need to worry about it as such because it doesn't smell, or you won't even notice it's there. You will just see the poop, there. Other than the visual noticing, there is no other thing that you can even notice about it. So it's fine. For me, it has just worked out well because it's a Bisleri bottle, so it's a cylindrical shape. So the poop always settles on the bottom. And since I'm feeding more leaves from the top, so the leaves settle on one above the other. So the caterpillars end up on the topmost leaves anyway, so they are at the top and there are a couple of leaves and then there's poop. which, and the poop obviously keeps going down because gravity, and you know, it kind of just rolls at the bottom. So I don't really clean it every day. I just clean it once the butterfly has flown off and the process has ended. It may be icky for you, but honestly, I don't notice it. I don't even see it. I mean, it's just not there for me. It's so, I just like let it be. And again, like, it has not really bothered the caterpillars or the butterflies or me, so I just let it be for now. The caterpillar will eat the leaves every day. Please ensure that you give them fresh leaves every day, because they will eat a lot. And once they have eaten their way, once it has grown, it will go into a cocoon, and you know, it will just be there till it's ready to come out as a butterfly. So yeah, so then it's just on them. You just have to wait and watch. This process takes about 3 to 4 weeks to a month, and depending on the stage cycle and you know, when you add them to your to the basket, it may just like, you know, it roughly takes around a month for it to emerge. So it is a slow process, but you will see also, like, you know, it's gone into the cocoon. There is a development every day. The only thing you need to take care of is that while you're feeding them and, you know, you're taking care of them, or if you're cleaning the basket and, you know, the box and everything, just don't interfere way too much with them. Just don't disturb them a lot. Let them be. Do it as a side say. Don't, like, you know, really go too close to them, because that may just disturb them a little bit, and so they will also get a little hostile. So not even hostile, they can't do much. Like, there's nothing that they can do. They won't like come and attack you, but still, don't do that. Of course, don't do that. So once they emerge from the cocoon, they won't start flying immediately. They will take a couple of hours, like, you know, 1 or 2 hours for them to, like, you know, get used to their wings and, you know, get used to the flying process. And once you think that, you know, it has emerged, and, you know, it's been like an hour that it has emerged from the cocoon, just open the flap and keep the door of the basket or something, and it will just figure its way out, and it will fly away when it's ready to fly away. Now the thing is that I have never, like, you know, most of the time they emerge out of the cocoon at night, so I have never really seen it emerge out of a cocoon. So for me, whenever I wake up in the morning and I see the, oh, it's there, you know, it has already flapped around a lot and it has already, like, you know, gotten used to its wings and all, so I just open the lid and keep, and they just fly away in its natural time whenever they are ready to fly away. At times they are not able to figure it out. At times they just, like, you know, have kept them there for like 2 hours and they just haven't figured out how to fly away. That time maybe you can assist them. So what I do is, like, you know, I just take like a bark of a tree or something, or a stick, and just try and, like, you know, get them. I just keep it there, so it kind of hops onto the stick, and once it hops onto the stick, I take it out and I place it on a tree, or, you know, by plant or a flower. Or at times, once it just comes out and it flies away, so then, you know, you can just let it be. It will go find nectar, and, you know, they will come and lay babies again on your plant later, hopefully. And the process again starts. So once it flies away, then I'll just wash the entire the bottle and keep it ready for when the next caterpillar comes in. Well, that's the process. If you have any more queries, please comment down below. I will respond to you. And thank you for watching this video. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Bye.